So the first major decision, and I believe to be the most important decision, is deciding on the groove. Over the Rainbow is typically done as a ballad, which would sound like this. Today, I do not want to include that as one of our options. I want to do something different. So the first groove that I'm going to bring up is a bossa nova groove. Option number two is a faster Latin rhythm. So this time that melody is actually going to go a little bit faster, but the underlying rhythm is also going to be faster. It's more like a samba. And that'll sound something like this. Option number three is actually changing the time signature. The song is originally in 4-4, but sometimes it's nice to change the time signature and do a 4-4 in 3-4. So the next one, option number four, is a different time signature, and what I'm basically doing is combining one measure of four with one measure of three. Obviously, four plus three, you're gonna get seven, so 7-4. So if you heard that, you might not even think, oh, that's an odd time signature, that's 7-4. You might not recognize it right away. Maybe you would, but it doesn't. To me, it doesn't sound weird. It just sounds nice. It's fun to play along with that rhythm. You could do it at a faster 7-4 as well, which would sound something like this. So one of those five decisions, if you can choose which one you think fits this song the best, then I will choose that for my arrangement. So the next major decision that I like to make is the very beginning, the intro. Intro is very important. It basically like sets up the scene. I chose several different options. The first one, often these older classic songs like Over the Rainbow, Autumn Leaves, so on, they have a verse that goes along with it, and people aren't so familiar with it, but it's an option to do as an intro. So option number two is to do a pedal intro, and often you do that with the five. It's called the five pedal intro. It's kind of a standard intro that you can use on all kinds of different music. So the five being the fifth note of the scale of E flat major would be B flat. So your left hand's going to be playing a B flat pedal tone, and the right hand's going to be changing harmony on top. For instance, E flat major 7, F minor 7, G minor 7, F minor 7. Or you could do something a little more interesting like E flat major 7 and maybe like an E major 7 and go back to E flat. You can alternate between those two. I kind of like that sound. So it would sound something like this. Thank you. next one is a vamp intro. So a vamp intro basically is setting up the groove without the melody. Usually it's a two-bar vamp, and I'll show you just a really simple basic one that you can use on a lot of different songs if they're in a major key, which is the one and the flat seven. So, the option number four is to play the A sections. This song, the form goes A, A, B, A. So to play the first two A sections in the sort of a ballad, rubato format, and then go into the rhythm that you choose from section B. Option number five is absolutely no intro at all. Just start right on the tune. So the next part I'd like to talk about is reharmonization. That sounds complicated. Well, reharmonization is basically changing the chords from the original chords to something different. I don't like to do too much of that, but I do like to create variation in my arrangements and do a certain amount at the right times, add some cool reharmonization. So basically you hear the same melody, but when you change the chord, you change the sound, you totally change the color of it, and you can hear it in a brand new light. The first one is actually sort of a standard reharm that a lot of jazz musicians do. It's kind of become the standard reharm for this song, and I'll start with that one. Now I'm gonna play the end of the B section, and then the reharm will take place on the last A section. Option number two is to start from the same chord, which is the flat five. Basically, we talked about the five, lower it one down, and you get the flat five. So this one, instead of doing what I just did, I'm gonna start with the flat five and move down chromatically until I get to C, and then that's gonna take me to the F minor on the fifth bar of A. So it will sound something like this. Instead of that, we could also go up a half step and go to B, and then that would create maybe a B major 7, because it's a major 3rd relationship. So starting from there, and then moving up in either half steps or whole steps, depending on what fits best with the melody. So option number four is to go up a half step from all of the chords in this part. So the chord, the progression, the original progression goes E flat, C, G, B flat, E flat, A flat, A, and then G, C. So instead of that, we're gonna go up a half step. So E flat becomes E, C would become C sharp, G would become A flat, and so on. It would sound something like this. Thank you. the last option, number five, is to create a random root movement with the left hand. Okay, so the way that I do this, so the idea is that not to think really very hard about what the root selection that you're doing, almost pick randomly, but you're going to then decide what type of chord, for instance, major, minor, dominant, flat seven, whatever, that fits best with that root and that melody. All right, so the roots that I chose, I really didn't think very hard about it. I just kind of tried to choose very quickly and randomly, is this movement. So I'll play the root movement first. If you hear it like that, you don't think it sounds very interesting. That sounds kind of weird, right? But you'd be surprised. If you add the right voicing and the right chord to it, it can actually work. So for instance, what I mean by that is you have the root, the first one being G flat, the melody note being an E flat. All right, so with that relationship in mind, what kind of chords could you possibly use? Well, you could use a sort of a major seven. You could use a minor six. You could use a dominant seven. You could use a lot of different chords if the melody is a sixth. So I chose to use a G flat major seven for this one. I will definitely at some point talk more in detail about these different concepts. Today I just wanted to cover the general idea of it, but later on I will get more in detail with these reharmonization ideas. Alright, the next concept I wanted to talk about was a modulation. So often in arrangements, if you want to really bring up the energy of the song, like lift it to a new level, you can modulate the song into a new key. Typically you modulate up. If you modulate down, it tends to bring the music down. It's an option, and there's times where that might work, but most of the time you're going to modulate up. That kind of really lifts the music up. So you can modulate in different ways. So the first option that I have, and typically when I modulate, I will use it at the end of a song, when I come back to the melody at some point in the song. I think in this song, it works best to modulate on the final B section. So the second time through after a little piano solo and go back to the melody at the B section to modulate that up. So the first one is to go up a half step. So we're gonna move from B flat and go to E. And I will end up modulating on the chord before the B section. So the chord before normally would be a B flat seven. If I wanna modulate to B, then I'll play a B seven sus, basically an A major seven sus, and that will take me to the next key, E major. It will sound something like this. The next one is to go up a whole step. So if we go up a whole step, we're gonna go from E flat to F, and so I would need to play a C7 sus chord. And that would sound something like this. Could go up a minor third, so from E flat to G flat, which means I would need to play a D flat seven to get us to that key. That would sound like this. A major third. So in that case, we're going to go from E flat to G, which means that we would need a D sus or a C major seven over D to get us there. That would sound like this. kind of sounds cool because you end up going down a half step to D, which seems like a logical move. And the last option, number five, is to do no modulation. All right, so sometimes the song doesn't need to modulate. Sometimes it can be overkill. So that's definitely an option here. So if you don't modulate, it's just gonna be. So the final decision that I would like to discuss is the ending. How you end a song is often the most important thing that you might do. If you end it right and you end it well, it leaves people with a really good feeling. But if you mess up the ending, even if you played great the whole song, people will just remember that you messed up the ending. So it's really important to do a nice ending. This song kind of has a built-in ending to it because it has a coda at the end. So just ending it normal like that would sound like this. Option number two is to do up a half step and up a half step on a different chord other than the tonic, other than the one chord. So the song ends on an E flat major and the melody is an E flat. So what you can do is go up a half step and end on an E first before you resolve it to the one and sort of delay the final resolution. And if you do that, it creates a major seventh relationship. So a major seven chord would sound nice. And this would sound something like this. You can do other chords, for instance, you could end on a D flat major 7, or a G flat major 7, an A major 7, a B major 7. And you could also combine two of those together, like B, then E, and then finish with E flat. So there's a lot of different variations that you can use using that concept. The next one that we could do is a vamp ending. Instead of going straight to the coda, we can create sort of a little mini, almost like a mini solo, a little vamp at the end, and really extend the ending. So we could use the same chord as the intro, the 1 flat 7 vamp, and it would sound something like this. Definitely carry on longer or even go to the coda after that. So there's a lot of options there. And number four is kind of similar to the reharmonization that we talked about, going to the flat five, but instead to do that at the ending. And this works a lot on a lot of like jazz standard classic songs, is to, instead of ending on the one, end on the flat five and go down chromatically to finally end at the one. Now it sounds something like this. Option. We also did this on the intro, is you can also do it on the ending, is to create a 5-pedal ending. It's sort of almost like the same as the intro, is create this floaty atmospheric ending. Now it sounds something like this. So, thank you so much for watching my video, and thank you for participating in the arrangement. I'm going to wait about 6 weeks and wait till the poll results come in, and then I will take all the ideas and whatever has the highest score, use those to create the arrangement. I'll decide the little details, but you have helped me decide the major important details for my next arrangement. So thank you so much, and please subscribe to my channel. I will talk more in detail about some of these ideas and concepts in upcoming videos. So stay tuned. Thank you so much.